Day and this 85th league derby between Manchester City and Manchester United could turn out to be one of the big games of the season. Victory for United would confirm their position at the top of the table. Victory for City would lift them to within a point of their neighbours and confirm their challenge. The City lineup is as expected, with Alan Oates having his third game in the side since his recovery from injury, and with Wyn Davis getting his first taste of Manchester rivalry. And despite a scare, Colin Bell is fit to play in the number 8 shirt and to be team captain in a derby game for the first time. He's had knee trouble and spent Thursday and yesterday in hospital, and it remains to be seen whether that was adequate preparation for a game like this. United's team includes two players who made their debut for the club in a derby game, Alex Stepney, who made his first appearance just over 5 years ago, and young Tommy O'Neill, who was tossed in for the last game of last season and has never looked back since. Now a third name is added to the list, Sam McElroy, a boy from Belfast, only 3 months past his 17th birthday, and getting his chance today because Dennis Law is unfit. Of course, we have a packed main road for this 85th derby game in a series that began 77 years ago this week with a 4-all draw. The overall record now stands at City 25 victories, United 30, and there have been 29 draws. Today's referee is Mr. Ray Tinkler from Boston in Lincolnshire, and the flag waving and stud inspecting is being done by Mr. Garner from Liverpool and Mr. Brooks from Sutton in Ashfield. The teams have changed ends, and so it's Manchester City in the white shorts and light blue tops. Manchester United in the dark socks, which may be the best identification. United kicking from right to left. Number 7 here, Mike Summer. Bell close to him. Tommy O'Neill sticking to his task well and giving away the opening corner in the first 30 seconds. Actually, Tony Dunnett was. Summerby with the corner. And that was Doyle's header. Good, powerful flick, but wide of Stepney's goal. Tony Dunnett. Been prominent in these opening minutes for City. Charlton. Cut out by Lee. Mellor on his left. And Donaghy overlapping as well. There's the ball for Donaghy. And a good interception by Morgan. And good cooperation from his goalkeeper. Stepney made an awful lot of ground to cover up that back pass and save the corner. So it's a throw-in. Willie Donaghy. Wyn Davis gowling for United. Donaghy again. United left an awful lot of responsibility on Stepney. Miller, Doyle. The long one for Summerby. Too high. Run for Best. Shot pulled by Summerby on the blind side of the referee. Bell. Beautiful ball for Mellor. A half-hearted appeal there for handball by O'Neill. I don't think it was. Calm work by McElroy. Really looks as though this boy can play football. Certainly comes to this game with a big reputation from the Central League side. O'Neill with the free kick, the first foul of the game. Who Somerby, but intercepted by Dunn. Best trying to play it back to him. Somerby. McIlroy chasing him back because Dunn is upfield. Lee coming in, handball. Good acting performance by Francis Lee. Lee still appealing to Mr. Tinkler. Kid Bobby Charlton. Oops. And a big cheer for Joe Corrigan's first touch. Somerby's throw, Lee chasing hard and going over that tackle from James brilliantly. And a great cross! Stepney is injured. He made a brave dive and so did Wyn Davis. But the credit there was all for Francis Lee. Great determination in his run to the right. And Wyn Davis meeting his cross as it came over and just putting it wide. Trying to wriggle round Donaghy, couldn't do it. Ten minutes to go to half time and still no score between City and United. But both sides have made mistakes that make you feel that this hasn't the look of a goalless draw about it at all. Best. And Francis Lee is going to be booked for that. And Malcolm Musgrove is being called on, and this is turning into a very expensive football season for Francis Lee, who has said that he will give £50 to charity if he's booked. Well, he was booked last Saturday, and again now, having already been in front of the disciplinary commission this season. And he's suggesting absolutely graphically that it was a dive. Mr. Tinkler was very close to it. From this distance, I must say I've seen worse this season. Sadler with the free kick. Mella. O'Neill for United. Kid leaving the throw in for Gowling. And this will be a long one. Boom. Billy Morgan, good dummy. He's just got himself into more trouble. No, he hasn't. He's made a good cross. And that was box header Charlton. It wouldn't have counted, I think. Certainly wouldn't have counted if Brian Kidd had made contact. He was in an offside position, and I suspect that would have been enough to disallow the goal in any circumstance. Gary Charlton. Best. Somerby to Lee. Bella's header to Davis, Francis Lee, chip forward for Bell, that could have been it, Stepney got out well to smother, City have been looking for that move all through this half, Stepney a good save then, when it really mattered. Has now gone at the end of a half which has lasted just over 50 minutes, has been packed with incident and has introduced to us a player of whom we are going to hear a great deal in the future, Sam McElroy, 17 years old from Belfast, playing his first game of league football and the scorer of the only goal so far that gives us this half-time scoreline, Manchester City 0, Manchester United 1. And Manchester United begin the second half with substitute John Aston on in place of Tony Dunn, helped off just before the interval. Aston now going to have his studs checked by Mr. Tinker. Mr. Tinker quite satisfied. And it looks as though Aston may well be lining up in Tony Dunn's position to do a job as a short notice fullback. Doyle's long ball, James clearance, Lee. Best beaten by Brooks tackle, now Aston. Oakes back to Corrigan. Manchester United leading by 1-0. And no doubt much encouraged by the way they resisted City's initial challenge in the first 25 minutes. Summerby. Davis. Headed away by James. McIlroy. Kidd. McIlroy couldn't change direction in time. Dowling to Bobby Charlton. Vestry on the left. Here he is, put in by a good pass from Charlton. McIlroy steps over it and Kidd scores. No trouble. Manchester City in absolute disarray. With that pass from Charlton to Best, McIlroy lets it go on and nobody picking up Kidd at all. Really, Manchester City's defence there are virtually non-existent. Brian Kidd the scorer, his fourth goal of the season, and Manchester City now with a long road to run. Doyle's header. Fine header it was too. George Best. No challenge from Oakes. Well cut out there by Mella. Lee. The flick on for Donaghy. O'Neill waiting to challenge. Donaghy so cool. Kidd. had nobody to play the ball to, so tried a speculative one from way out on the line, and Corrigan had to do all he knew to get it over. Bobby Charlton is going to take the corner. Morgan staying with him if he wants to play it short, but I think he's going to take a long one. With the ball in the air, and it must have crossed the line. And Aston will be unpopular for that. They're mighty close to being definable as kicking the ball away. Gowling's header, and it's only come as far as Mellon. Good interception by Best. Everybody wanting it for City. Booth is still up there. He's under that now. Lee, and Fatler only just got it away for a corner in time. Just under 5 minutes to go. City now must find some reserves of energy from somewhere. Somerby. Good shot! Mike Somerby, a magnificent shot, but you will go a long, long way before you'll see a better save than that from Stepney. Stepney there outside his far post, having really produced the save of the match and one of the saves of the season. And he's there again and lost it! Somerby! Misses and the mistakes. Honour, I feel, has been